worship unto you today, oh God. Lord, anoint them, bless them, keep them, and make them whole today, oh God. Oh, Father God, we want to thank you, Lord. And we want to praise your holy and your righteous name, oh God. Oh, Father God, if we can ask everyone to just begin to stand up, just begin to lift your hands and begin to lift your voice and begin to worship the Master. Begin to worship him today like he deserves to be worshiped and to be lifted up and exalted in this place. So we want to thank you.
I saw Satan fall like lightning. I saw darkness run for cover. But the miracle that I just can't get over, my name is registered in heaven. I believe in signs and wonders. I have resurrection power. The miracle that I just can't get over, my name is registered in heaven. Yeah, my praise belongs to you forever. This is my testimony from death to life, 'cause grace rewrote my story. I'll testify by Jesus Christ the righteous, I'm justified. This is my testimony.
Hallelujah. We all have a testimony.
Come together, sons and daughters, bought with blood and washed in water. Sing the praises of the Spirit, Son and Father, our God. We'll finish what he started. Yes, our God will finish what he started.
Hallelujah. If we're not dead, there's still time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The next song is Rest on Us.
Spirit was moving over the water. Spirit, come move over us. Come rest on us. Come rest on us. As the Spirit was moving over the water, Spirit, come move over us. Come rest on us. Come rest on us. So calm down, Spirit, when you move. Make my heart pound. Will you fill the room? You're here and I know you are moving. I'm here and I know you will fill me. Calm down, Spirit, when you move, you make my heart pound. Will you fill the room? You're here and I know you are moving. I'm here and I know you will fill me.
That's when we come to meet Jesus. Oh, come and fill us afresh, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 We're here to meet the Lord. That's what we're coming to do, is meet the Lord. Don't worry who's around us. We're here to meet the King of Kings. We're here to meet the Lord of Lords. We're here to meet the Righteous One. Hallelujah.
Mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down, line you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down, line you won't tear down, coming after me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. And I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it, still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God.
Oh, yes. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your love.
Oh, what a savior.
Oh, what a savior. Isn't he wonderful? Sing hallelujah, Christ is risen. Bow down before him, for he is Lord of all. Sing hallelujah, Christ is risen. Oh, what a Savior.
He wants to hear you sing.
Isn't he wonderful? Sing hallelujah.
Jesus.
Praise you, God.
Hallelujah.
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 God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to ask the King of Glory to come in. We're going to ask the King of Kings to come in.
Yes, the world will say you are God. Every man will say you are King. So let's start.
Yeah.
just waiting on you to invite him in. He's standing. I'm standing here waiting, my child. Just invite me in. King of glory, fill this place. King of glory, fill our minds. King of glory, fill our homes. King of glory, fill our jobs. He wants to be with you. He wants to walk with you. He wants to stand right beside you. He said he would never leave you nor forsake you. King of glory, King of healing, he will bring you peace. He'll bring you comfort. He'll bring you joy. Whatever you need, there's nothing too small. He wants to ride along with you when you go to work. He wants to go through your day with you as you go from here to there. As you cook dinner, as you make breakfast, God wants to be right beside you. Amen. Yes, it's that simple. Amen. He wants to be with you.
Yes, yes, yes.
He said, I'm here, my child. I care all about you. If he cares about the fowls in the air, and the lilies in the field, how much more does he care about his creation that was made in the likeness of him? How much more? He's such a good God. He's such a great Father. King of glory, fill this place. God, we just want to be with you. We just want to be with you. We just want to bask in your presence, God. That's what we come to do, is to meet you, Father. Lord, meet us here. Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
To be in the presence of the Lord, because in him there is fullness of joy at his right hand. Woo, God. God, we just love you. Hallelujah. 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 I don't know if I don't want this time to end because I've had such a rough week, or just that we just really need to press in some more, just really bask in the presence of the Lord some more. I don't think it's time to move on just yet, and I know that some of you may be ready to move on, but I think that this is a time that we really need to just get into the presence of the Lord just a little bit more. You don't have to wait on anybody to pump you or to prime you. You can get into the presence of the Lord and just bask in his presence all by yourself. You can just worship him. You don't even have to wait to hear me give a prompt. You can just go in and bless the name of the Lord even right now. You can just glorify him because he's good. You can worship him because he's great. You can just thank him for who he is because of what he's done for you. Oh, God is so great. He is so good. He is so mighty. He is so true. He's the King of kings. He's the Lord of lords. He's the great I am. He's El Shaddai. He's Jehovah Jireh. He's Jehovah Nisi. He's Jehovah Mikadesh. He's Jehovah Rophi. He's Jehovah Sikkenu. He's Jehovah Nisi. He's the one who loves you. He's his banner over us is love. He's our healer. He's Jehovah Jireh. That means he provides for you in every single situation that you are going through. Oh God, you are King. God, we lift you up above everything that is going on in our lives right now, God. I lift you up, God, above the projects that I'm working on, oh God. I lift you up, oh God, above the mountains that are in front of me, oh God. I lift you up, oh God, above the hurdles that I'm dealing with even right now, Father God. I lift you up, oh God, above the frustrations that are going on. I lift you up, God, above the irritations that I'm dealing with, oh God. I lift you up, Father God. I magnify you, Lord God, because you're bigger than God. Everything that I'm dealing with, oh God, you're greater than, oh God, the situations that I'm coming up against, oh God. You're bigger than, Lord God, the people that I'm dealing with, oh God. You're mightier than, oh God, even my job, Father God. Lord, you are the great I am. God, you are the bright and morning star. God, you are the Prince of Peace. Hallelujah, Lord. I magnify you, God. I look to the hills from whence cometh my help. I know, Lord God, that our help comes from you and only you, because you are the maker of heaven and earth. Your word says that you never slumber, that you never sleep. God, so we don't have to worry. God, we don't have to be restless. Lord God, we can just look to you. We can lean on you. We can trust in you. We can lay on you. God, we can kneel on your word, because your word never fails. Your word never returns to you void. God, we've been dealing with a lot this past week, Lord God. There's been so much that has been going on, Father God. We've heard death after death after death after death. We've heard problem after problem after problem after problem, God, but we give it all over to you, Father God. It's nothing that we can carry ourselves, Lord God. Even when we're overloaded, Lord God, we lay it at the foot of the cross. Lord God, even when we're overwhelmed, oh God, we choose to look to you, Father God. We look to you, Father God, because you are the only one, God. You're faithful and you're true. Oh God. Oh my God. God, in those lonely times, Father God, when someone may feel like they're all alone, like nobody else is there for them, Father God, I pray, Holy Spirit, that you come alongside them. And yet you whisper in their ear that you are right there. God, I thank you for the direction that you continue to give us. I thank you, God, that you continue to lead and guide us. And Lord God, we just bless you for keeping us in our right mind. Thank you, God, for giving us peace that passes all understanding. God, peace in the midst of the situations that we're going through, when everybody thinks that we should be out of our mind or that we should be going crazy. Lord God, you give us peace. The peace that will never end. Bless you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We love you, God. We love you, God. We love you, God. We love you, God. We thank you, God. Oh, God, we enter into this time, Lord, where the world remembers to thank you. God, we continually thank you every single day. But, Lord God, we want to say a special appreciation for who you are in our lives, God. We thank you, God, that you continue to provide. We thank you, Father God, that you continue to keep us in our right mind. We thank you, God, that you're a prayer answering God. We thank you, God, that you keep us through the watches of the night. We thank you, Father God, that you keep our children and our grandchildren. We thank you, God, that you keep our families, oh God. We thank you, Father God, that you even watched over us, Lord God, as we traveled and went into the byways, oh God, and the highways, oh God. We thank you, Father God, for bringing us back home safely, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, that we are still here, God, because many have gone before us, oh God, but you still have us here, God. And as long as we have breath in our bodies, God, you have something for us to do. And so we thank you, God. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. God, you're great. God, you're good. We depend on you, God, because we can't even breathe without you, Lord. You're the very air that we breathe. You're the song that we sing. We honor you on this day, God. God, I just pray, Father, over Pastor Herman as he's preparing to deliver the word that you have already placed on the inside of him. We pray, Father God, that you would saturate him even right now, God. That you would touch his belly, God. Oh, God, and that you would stir up the word that is on the inside of him, oh, God. That your word would come forth, oh, God. Oh, Lord God, that it would pierce through the darkness, oh, God. Lord God, let him be the first hearer of your word, oh, God. And as he hears it from you, God, that he gives it away. I pray, God, that you open our ears to hear from you, God. Open our hearts to receive what you're saying. God, give us understanding. As your word says in Ephesians, God, oh, God, that the eyes of our understanding would be opened, oh, God. That we may know the hope of your calling, oh, God. Lord God, that you would give us the understanding and wisdom from above. And so we bless you now, God. We praise you. We magnify you. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, if you can, greet each other, love on each other, and we have children's church today as well.
Good morning, good morning. Good morning, good morning. Good morning, good morning. Hey, Shia. Good morning, good morning, everybody. Good morning, good morning. I'm gonna say it again. Oh, shit. All right, well, good morning, BWC. Good morning to those that are in the house. Good morning to those that are online in the virtual world. We say good morning. Thank you all for being here. There's so much love in the room. I'm trying to give everybody a chance to get all the hugs and all those things. Somebody put a finger up. I think they needed a second. Good morning. I'm trying. I'm good morning. There's so much to talk about today, Mike. I don't understand. It's just so much to talk about. Good morning. Good morning. Yeah, if we don't bring it together in a few moments, I may be feel the need to sing. So it be your own family. Good morning. Good morning. You know what? Sometimes we got to take a moment just to love on one another, whether it's during service, after service, before service. And so, you know, thank everybody for taking a seat. But we enjoy the time, the Love Fest, because it is definitely needed. So thank you all. For those that are online right now, or if you're watching it later, we're throwing you air hugs, too. We love to see you as well. I'm going to jump right into the announcements. So don't forget, we have different prayer opportunities throughout the week. We have noonday prayer. We will not have Thursday morning prayer because Thursday is Thanksgiving. So we won't be on the line at 6:30 in the morning. But if you want to pray on the prayer line, please reach out to the majors so they can get you on the schedule, okay? Because Mama Major run a tight shift. She'll get you out there on the dates that is available. All right? Now, I'm going into today is the last day to get my mom or myself the name that you want to put in for a turkey basket. See one back there? I'll get you in a minute. But please, today is the last day. We will be taking care of the house and the and whatever we have left over. We'll pull names that we gathered from the food pantry. So please make sure, do not call us tomorrow. It'll be too late. We need them today, okay? So if you got a name, we need it when? Thanks, Paul. Paul, back there in the back. Thanks, Paul. All right, and those that we're going to give the turkey baskets out to, we'll be calling tomorrow afternoon starting at probably about 3:30 for the times that you can pick it up, but will need to be picked up no later than Tuesday at 5:50, okay, because we leave the pantry at 6 o'clock. So please make sure if you're putting somebody's name in that the number is available and they're going to be able to pick it up on Monday and or Tuesday, okay? Got it. Moving on. For those that are interested in evangelizing, we have a meeting today immediately after service. I know we all evangelize every day in everything we do, right? Because in every way we move, we should be evangelizing. But specifically, if you want to learn about an activity or what we're about to do, please, please, please join us after service today in the fellowship hall. Immediately after service, please plan to attend. And I said it loud for you in the back, okay? All right, now we have Christmas Caroling event that is going to be on December the 16th. If you're interested in participating, we need people for registration, hot chocolate, and sing. As you all know, I can sing, so I will be singing. Thanks, best friend. We are signing up. I didn't say That's right. I didn't say my mic would be on. I just said I'd be singing, okay? So Christmas caroling, please sign up. And then also, it's Thanksgiving this week, right? So we want to say whoop, whoop. Thank you for Thanksgiving. But fast forward, it's almost time to start decorating for Christmas. Whoop, 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 whoop. Raise your hand if you already have some Christmas decorations up in your house. Slowly but surely, I at least got a placemat and a couple of trees up. But anyway, so we're going to decorate the church on December the 6th and 7th, if needed, from 6 to 8. So if you're available on December the 6th, from 6 to 8, please join us as we decorate the church, make the house festive as we always do. We're so grateful that Angie always has this vision to put together, so we'll be doing it. But on the 3rd, we're going to ask if you can stay back after service just for a couple of minutes. We just want to bring everything downstairs, okay? So Angie's going to already be there. She's going to say, move this, move that. If you know Angela, you know she already got a plan and everything, so it'll be real quick. We just need to bring it downstairs. So after service, so on next Sunday, don't wear your highest heels and your good shoes, Mike, because we're going upstairs to bring everything downstairs, okay? I think that's all I have for the announcements. Oh, so I have a praise report to share with the church. There's people that already know that they can't stop moving in their seats, Miss Yvonne. So, and I'm going to give a little bit of a story. So about a few months ago, the church submitted for a food pantry grant, right? And I think we asked for about $5,000, $6,000, and we got a no. We didn't get it, right? And I was a little discouraged. I don't know about everybody else, but I was a little discouraged. So fast forward, we submitted for the grant again. This time, we were very detailed on what we wanted the Lord to do. We were very detailed in the grant request and all of that. This time, we got awarded the $12,900 for our food pantry. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes. Hallelujah. So we are excited about the remodeling we're going to be able to do in the pantry. We're going to be able to get more refrigerators and freezers and shelving, which means we'll be able to get more food in, because for those that are out there, Miss Juana, we out there working hard. But for those that are out there, Angie and co-pastor, pastor, the Joy 50 Plus, y'all, we are working hard out there. And the numbers, we used to be about 80, 90 every Tuesday and Thursdays. Those numbers are reaching to 130, 128 every Tuesday and Thursday, y'all. And we got to move fast, because the line is down the street blocking traffic at some point. And so we don't want the city to come and we don't want people to complain. So we're definitely, and whenever you can give a helping hand, we appreciate it. If you're home praying, we appreciate it. If you're sowing a seed, we appreciate it. We just appreciate this house. And so now I'm off. Oh, if you need anything, call us, right? I got to make sure I say that. If you need anything, call us, reach out to us. We are here. Mike, I'm going to pass. Mic check.
Good morning, good morning. All right, y'all ready for your tithes and offerings?
Yeah.
All right, y'all ready? Hopefully y'all ready for what I'm getting ready to read to y'all, because this ain't from me, so. just preface that right now. My wife said earlier, she said, so how did you choose that? I said, I didn't choose this, so. Because I did not choose it, I will say that I am the first to say I'm very guilty of it. So let's get to James chapter 4. Not going to read the whole chapter, just a little snippet of it. Those of y'all who may know what James chapter 4 is may know what some of this is about. If you don't, then feel free to read it after church. I'm just going to give you a little bit of a snippet of it. So verse 13 says, come now, you who say, today or tomorrow we will go to such and such a city, spend a year there, buy and sell and make a profit, whereas you do not know what will happen tomorrow. For what is your life? It is even a vapor that appears for a little time and vanishes away. Here's my favorite part here, because this is what I do. I'm just going to confess that right now. It says, instead you ought to say, if the Lord wills, we shall live and do this or that. But now you boast in your arrogance. All such boasting is evil. And I was like, Lord, why you got me saying that? And I realized, you know, we like to share good news, but sometimes the best thing we can share is silence. I mean, not like that, though, but it's just because sometimes everything that we share is not for the uplifting of the Lord, is it? It's for the uplifting of ourselves or our circumstances that God has kind of changed for us. So we want the the recognition for what God has done instead of recognizing God and giving him the recognition for what he's done. So sometimes it's best to just be silent, just move in silence, or say, Lord, what should I say? And if you struggle with being silent, just think about all the things that goes through your mind when you want to say something or you want to get recognized and you don't get recognized. So let's say you're in a room and everybody gets recognition for something, but not you. And then you kind of feel a certain kind of way, a certain kind of puffiness. And I get those moments. I'm like, Lord, what are you showing me? Because I'm getting puffed up at not being recognized, you know? And I'm like, yeah, I know, Pastor, it's not my word, it's his word. And so I just say, you know, sometimes the silence is what God recommends. If he tells you to speak something on his behalf, he will give you something to speak. If not, then you are speaking on your behalf. We're headed into 2024, new year, new me. You know how we do all this stuff. And everybody likes to boast and proclaim about what they're going to do. But no one says, for 2024, I simply want God's will to be done in the lives of myself and those around me. Say that, leave it at that, and whatever God does, unless he tells you to share it, keep it to yourself. Amen. That's it. That's all I got to say. That being said, there's several ways you can give. That's our website, www.beltadadworship.org. You click on the giving link. You can give during the collection in a few minutes. There's Cash App at $BWCCI. There's Venmo at BWCCI. You can also drop it off during the week. Just contact us ahead of time, or you can mail it to us. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you, Lord, for all that you have done for us, Father. We pray, Lord, that we embrace the humility that you have required of us, Lord. Lord, give us your will for our lives, Father. Give us the words to say, Father, when your blessings are falling down on us, Lord. The same as when we're going through struggles, Lord, that we cry out to you in private and sometimes in public, Lord. Let our words be your words, Father. Let those words, Father, of admonition and praise fall on your ears first, Lord, before it falls on the world, Father. And that whatever the world hears, Father, it is what you have us to say to them, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
I was in certain danger, caught in the crossfire of hope and regret. Thought I could be my own savior, but I'm sinking fast. 'Cause it's too much to handle alone in the battle. I'm desperate for you, Lord. Heart under fire, facing defeat, so close to surrender to my enemies. But love came from heaven to fight for me. When I am defenseless, you climb in the trenches, the trenches with me. Faithful from the beginning, you felt my pain, you have been where I've been, and I hear you say, it is finished, it is written, we win in the end. Heart under fire, face in defeat, so close to surrender. But love came from heaven to
Hallelujah. Whew, hallelujah. Hallelujah. You bless your name forever. Before I get started, I just want to do two things. Praise God. I'm glad you feel better, Uncle Bud. I had to get that off my chest. And I just want to pray real quick. Father, we thank you for Brother Albert. Father, I pray and I speak healing over his body. I speak it from the top of his head down to the soles of his feet. I speak life over him. I pray, Father, that you would do all things well. And so, God, we bless you. We praise you and we honor you. You said in your word that healing is the children's bread. And so, God, we thank you for divine healing, divine intervention. And, Father, I pray over Pastor Tina the same thing, God. And, God, over every member of our church, Father, and even in our families, Father, who is down, Father, who's not feeling well, Father, I bless you for them, God. And I speak life over them, God. I speak healing. We bless you. We praise you. And we honor you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. And amen. If you have your Bibles, I won't be before you long. Two people already did some of the points that the Lord had gave me. So, amen. I want you to turn with me to the book of Ephesians, chapter number 4, verse number 25. While I do that, I'll just get myself focused. I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Because you care for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up. And I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. That's why my heart is filled with praise. My heart, my mind, my soul belongs to you. Paid the price for me way back on Calvary. And now I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. We sing praises to your name. Oh, Lord, praises to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. We sing praises to your name. Oh, Lord, praises to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Have y'all found it yet? There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Hallelujah, God. The overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. Hallelujah. Leave the night. Hallelujah. Still you. You're overwhelmed. Hallelujah. 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 It's overwhelming, never ending, reckless love from God. I want you to remember that I had a message I wanted to give you. The Lord told me to tell you something. It's going to be a little interesting, okay? So y'all pray for me. The book of Ephesians, chapter number 4. And incidentally, I'm just going to be honest with you. I had to sing that. A good part of it was worship, but the other part was whenever I decided to preach on this, it felt like my lungs just started closing up. And so I was just saying to the Lord and to the enemy, I'm going to do what I was called to do. And so the Lord allowed two people to give part of it. And so I'm going to finish the rest. It says, therefore, having put away falsehoods, let each of you speak the truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger, and give no opportunity to the devil. I love that part. All right, y'all ready? Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. Let the thief no longer steal, but rather let him labor, doing honest work with his own hands, so that he may have something to share with anyone in need. Okay. Let no corrupt talk come out of your mouths, but only such as is good for building up as it fits the occasion, that it may give grace to those who hear. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and slander be put away from you, along with all malice. And be kind to one another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ has forgiven you. Father, we bless you. We praise you. We lift your name on high. We sing praises to your name. In Jesus' name, amen. You can be seated. The Lord wanted me to talk to you for a little bit because we had started dealing with the scripture that talked about that he loves you. And it says, I pray for you that the eyes of your understanding be enlightened, that you might know what is the hope of your calling and what God stands to inherit, the riches of his inheritance in the saints. And the Lord began to deal with me on some of this, and so far we've gotten here. And if you notice, he gives a list of things for you to do. He says, put away all malice. And one of the things I like, he says, don't even give the opportunity to the devil. In other words, we're going to rob him of the opportunity to even put in work or to do dirt. He says, we're going to live our lives and govern ourselves and in worship and in honor and integrity in such a way that the devil don't even have a place or room to even operate. There are ways that we can do things. There are ways that we can move. There are things that we can do. There are things that we can shift and ways that we can position ourselves to be used by God and to be used by the enemy. God said in his word, I've set before you life and death, blessings and cursings. He says, choose life so that you and your children may live. He said, choose. The choice is yours. And I need to tell you that because he gives a list of things over in scripture that he talks about not doing, but I really want to focus on one. He says, put away all those things behind you, all malice. He talks about forgiving. Do you know that forgiveness is not just for the person who's being forgiven? Forgiveness is for you. Because I showed you a while back that you can't hold somebody down or hold somebody to something without holding yourself to it. The commandment to forgive is just as much for you as it is for anybody else. but I want to talk to you about this one. I took a rebuke one day from my college pastor when I was younger. And you know what he told me? He said, I was just talking. He said, you don't believe that. I said, what you mean I don't mean believe that? I might put him in on this, send him a link to this. But he said, you don't believe that everything you say had the ability to come to pass. And I said, why do you say that? He said, because if you did, you wouldn't say half the stuff you say. And the Lord told me to deal with this. He says, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth except for what is profitable, what is building up of others and brings grace to the hearer. Let no corrupt communication, therefore, proceed out of your mouth. Why? Because we are king's kids. And as prince and princesses in the earth, we have a mandate from our Father to speak his word, to speak whatever it is he says, to do and to be whatever it is he said to do and to be. Do you not know that the Bible says that the power of life and death is found where? In your tongue. And if we were created in God's image, I need to tell you now, I don't believe in manifesting the way they teach it now, because they border on witchcraft the way they teach it now. Some people teach it in a sense where they make it seem like that you could just manifest anything without God. And there is some truth to that, but you're practicing witchcraft. Can I be clear about that? But there is a way that we should talk. There is a thing that we should do where our speech lines up with our Father. Let me tell you why. Because if God says, let us create man in our own image and our own likeness after our own kind, and God says, let him have dominion, do you know that just like your heavenly Father, what you say is an edict? Do y'all hear what I'm saying? When you are a king's kid, when your Father is the King of Glory, what you say has a propensity to happen in your life. Check this out. How did God create the world? In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, right? Remember that? Let me quote it for you. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God did what? Hovered over the face of the water. What was he doing? Waiting on the Father to speak what was supposed to happen. And then it says, and God, sitting on his sovereign throne, he said, what did he say? Let there be. In other words, he wasn't asking for permission. He was saying, let there be. I want it to be. Make this happen. I'm a king and I speak, and whenever I speak, whatever I speak is law, and he says, let this happen. And there it was. And he did it over and over and over and over and over and over and over again. And that's how he created creation. And finally, God says, it is good. Well, what did God say was good? Everything that he said. And when we are God's creation, when we speak, we put things in the atmosphere. I came to tell you that words are spiritual containers, and they contain power to make happen, or authority to make happen whatever it is you're beginning to talk about. So what are we talking about? When you speak a thing, when you begin to talk, when you talk, there's power in your words. So God told me to tell you, watch your mouth. It's a good thing now, but let me tell you why. Because if you watch your mouth and you watch the things that are coming out of it, oh, you should see some of the things that are coming out of your mouth. The way when you talk, some people be like, I hear people all the time, well, I'm just blunt. No, you're just rude. Sometimes it's a difference between being blunt and being rude. Well, I just say the first thing that comes to my mind. That's not always a sign of strength. Y'all hear me? That is not always a sign of strength to say the first thing to come out of your mouth. Because what comes out of your mouth can either build up or tear down. Now, some things need to be torn down and rebuilt, but there is a power in that. Because as people of the kingdom of God, when we speak, do y'all remember this story right here? Check this out. God was going to destroy the whole thing. Y'all do know God about that life, don't you? And he was going to destroy the whole thing. And he rolled up. And he had this confrontation with Abraham and Sarah. Sarah laughed at what God said. God was like, is anything too hard for me? What you laughing for? I said it, and I'm going to make it good. And then he turned to Abraham, and he asked a profound question. He said, shall I hide from Abraham what I'm about to do? And what did Abraham do? He talked to God. I'm telling you, if you know how to talk right, and you know how to talk to God, you can make some things happen, baby. And Abraham said, you can't do that, God. That's not your nature to do that. You're the king of all the universe. You're the king of glory. And he says, God, permit me to say something to you. I know who you are, and I know what you do, and I know how strong you are. And he says, can I just ask you a question? He said, what if, God, what if? What if you find 10 people in that city that's good? God, like, come on, okay. If I find 10 people in there. Okay, God, hold up. God, first, wait a minute. First, I think he said 50 first. Then he said, well, what if it's, he finally got down to, what if it's 10? What if it's 5? What if it's 4? What if it's, you know you can push your luck with God? Not, I don't mean luck. You know you can push the envelope with God when you know how to talk to him and when you know his character and when you use his word. But God, who is rich in mercy, God has stopped a whole lot of things and done a whole lot of things because his people who were called by his name humbled themselves and sought his face and talked to him. God will do a lot of things if you know how to talk to God. He says, listen, when you know how to talk to me, when you understand my word, when you do what it is I said, he says, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Why? Because you build faith. Wives, when you talk to your husband a certain way, I'm telling you, we were created in God's image. Talk to him right. I promise you. Oh, baby, I like the way you move. Fellas, how many of y'all have done stuff just because your wife said it and just because she said it to you the right way? Don't lie. I'm guilty. Baby, thank you for doing that. Oh, ain't nothing. Let me tell you what else I can do. And I know she doing it to me, too. I know she banking me. But I still do it. Why? Because the power of life and death is in the tongue. Husbands, when you talk to your wives right, things change. Yes, sir. Oh, yeah. Yes, sir. It changed. Why? Because there's creative power and capability in your tongue. And where the tongue is the pen of a ready writer. And when you declare a thing, it will be so that light will shine on your path. Yeah. Y'all remember that story of Billie Jean? He was walking the video. Light was lighting up on his path. I'm telling you, listen, I know that may sound weird. I just had it in my mind, so I had to say it. But when you declare a thing, it will be so that light will shine in your path. When you talk and you speak the word, so powerful is the word of God. So powerful is the spoken word when it's used correctly that things are created by it. Jesus woke up, he was in the boat asleep. What did he do? He said, Master, don't you care that we perish? Woo, we scared. Jesus woke up, wiped the cold out of his eyes, and said, peace, be still. The winds and the waves obey. The word and speaking the word properly is so powerful that the centurion was calling and his servant was faithful, and his servant came to Jesus. He came to Jesus, and he was like, Jesus, will you heal my servant? And Jesus was like, yeah, let's go to your house. He said, no, don't worry about it. He said, look, my house ain't even worthy for you to be coming in. He said, you got that much power. I'm a centurion. I'm a Roman soldier. You know he had a nice house. But he said, my house ain't even worthy for you to step in. He said, but all I do know this. I say to this one, power of the word, go this place. I say to that one, power of the word, go this place. And they move. I say to this one, go this place. He said, you don't even have to come to my house. You don't even have to come to my city. You don't even have to come to my town. He said, speak your word only, and he'll be healed. He knew the power of talking to God and talking with God and speaking the word. Nowadays, we just say any old thing. Nowadays, we even listen to any old thing. I was listening to this rapper talking about why he stopped rapping, and he said that he was just finished performing, and he heard something, and something told him to go in the back room and go back behind the stage, and he wanted him to watch. He said he just heard something, just at random say it. He said he went and he sat in a chair where he could see the stage and he could see the people. And he says as he heard the next performer performing, he said he looked and he said he don't know what happened. He said, but he began to see stuff, the weird stuff. And he said he saw like dark shadows coming out of the person's mouth while they were talking, while they were rapping. And he says, and those dark shadows begin to go and go into the mouths of the people that were in the ears of the people that were listening. And he said, and then he saw their behavior change. And he said, and before long, they started shooting in the place where he was at. There's power in what you say. There's power in who you say it to. If you don't believe me, go to the store and just pick a random person and give them a compliment. Well, I like your hair. There are people who are walking around and haven't had anything nice to say to, nobody said anything nice to them in a week. And you say one thing and it changes their day. I got to go a little further for you. Pray for me. The power, I keep telling you there's power in your words, right? How many of you have ever had anybody say anything to you? Anytime during the course of your life that was painful and you still remember it to this day? That was painful and you still remember it to this day. You can be, I'm talking about 4 years old, somebody can say something to you and you will remember it your whole life. Why? Because the words are spiritual containers and they're filled with stuff. Do you know that there are angels and devils that are waiting on you to speak? So that they can have the authority and permission to operate in your life and carry out what it is you're saying. So God told me to tell you, even when you're talking about yourself, watch your mouth, watch what you say about my child. It ain't just about what you say about other people, but watch even what you say and believe about yourself. There's power in your tongue. There's power in your words. So then faith comes by hearing and what? So what he's saying is faith comes by hearing. Period. So if you're going to hear something, hear the word of God. Faith comes by hearing. You hear anything long enough, you'll believe it. Faith comes by hearing. And since you got to hear, hear by the word of God. Hear what the word is saying. Speak the word only. Speak it over yourself. Encourage it over yourself. Remember I told you a while back to say this, so great is the power of God on the inside of me that nothing can stand against him. Speak the word only. Declare it over yourself. Speak it over yourself. Speak it over yourself. And if you can't listen to it, I told my wife years ago, I don't even know if she remembers. I said, if something ever happened to me and I end up sick and in a coma or whatever, I said, I love you, honey. But if you just happen not to make it that day, I said, do me a favor, get the Bible on tape, the Bible on CD. And if I'm laying in the hospital bed in a coma or whatever, I said, just play it. Anytime, just play it, just play it. And we'll let whatever happen, happen. But all I want you to do, if you can't show up, and I love you, but just leave me with the word. Why? Because there's power in it. There's power in the word. Don't let nobody speak over you anything that's not in the word. Because I'm telling you, there are people who are waiting just to speak negativity and death over you. You ain't ever gonna be good for nothing but laying on your back. You ain't ever, you're gonna be dead before you get this age. You stupid, you dumb, you this, you that. You think you cute, but you ain't cute. You this, you that. Why are you watching me then? I came to tell you, your haters are really just those first admirers. They're people who've been admiring you and they don't know what to do with themselves. They're so busy watching you, they don't know what to do. And so they're trying to speak something negative over you. Let me tell you why. Because if they can speak something negative over you and you believe it, it gives them permission to be mediocre and substandard. Y'all heard me? The power of life and death is in the tongue. So when you're he said, don't let the sun go down on your wrath. In your marriages, don't let the sun go down on your wrath. In your relationship, don't let the sun go down on your wrath. Speak the word. Speak in love. Tell the truth in love. I got to go a little further now. It's going to seem like I'm contradicting myself. When somebody tells you the truth, if they tell you the truth in love, you got to make a choice. Am I going to be stuck in my feelings? Or am I going to honor the truth? Am I going to be an emotional toddler? Or am I going to honor the truth? See, when somebody speaks the truth for you in love, you got to accept it and honor it. God says, my word will not come back to me void, but it'll accomplish that which I sent it to do. Let me give you a few more, and I'll leave you alone. Oh, Lord told me to tell you this. Told me to give you a definition. Y'all ready? This one's going to sting a little bit. He got me on this one a long time ago, so I'm used to it. Any misrepresentation of truth, whether in word or in deed, whether through omission or commission, y'all know what I mean? Whether you do it purposely or you just leave it out. So you ready? Any misrepresentation of truth, whether in word or in deed, whether through omission or commission, whether in good intent or bad, is a lie. And a lie is a sin, and the paycheck for sin is. Do I need to repeat that again? All right. Any misrepresentation of truth, whether in word or in deed, whether through omission or commission, whether in good intent or in bad intent, is a lie. And a lie is a sin, and the paycheck for sin. It's true, though, because it grows up and becomes. It grows up and becomes. Remember, I told you words are seed. And when we plant stuff, whether it's good or bad in the earth, it grows up and becomes. Some of us need to stop praying for crop failure because we got negative stuff growing up with our harvest. He got me on this already. I'm good. I'm good. Last time he got when I was driving. Whew. I opened up my mouth, and he was like, you better hush. I need to say the definition one more time. I'm almost done. I'm up. Okay. We good. But, look, but bringing grace to others who hear, when you speak the truth, when you speak the truth, when you speak the truth, when you love, when you talk to people, when you say things, make sure it's seasoned with the word of God. Make sure it's seasoned with the word of God. Make sure it's seasoned with the word of God. Some of us have not received what God has called us to receive already because we're too busy talking it away. God is sending it. I want you to get this visual picture, okay? Because the Lord showed me this. God is sending it to you, and you like, nope. And God is sending it to you again, you're like, nope. How are you saying no? With your words? With the things that you say? With the attitude that you say it with? God is trying to send something. Nope. Nope. And God's word is sitting there crying to him, I'm just trying to go back to heaven, man, where I came from. Y'all know why I said that, right? My word will not come back void, but it will accomplish that which I sent it to do. I'm going to say it again so y'all hear it because it got me on it. Got me on it, right? It got me on it. That's why I've been doing sit-ups lately. That's why I'm deciding to do a little bit more. I'm deciding to do a little bit of workout. My word will not come back to me void, but it will accomplish that which I sent it to do. So you got a word running up to you. Brother John, can I bless you? John like, nope. He be like, John, I'm coming to get, nope. He like, bro, I can't get back into heaven. And he told me to go and accomplish this in your life. But every time I come up on you, you send me away. Can I please finish this so I can go back to heaven where I came from? I'm trying to, with blessings, I'll bless you with this and that and whatever, whatever. But you keep sending me back because you don't want to do or say or speak in line with what he told me. Got to go a little further for me, so pray for me, okay? You know the reason why we didn't get the grant the first time? Our sights were too low. Our sights were too low. Some of you, help me, Lord. It's going to sound weird, okay? So pray for me. Some of you have been praying for something, and God hadn't answered it because you hadn't asked it in the right vein. Okay. I just thought about something. He got me. How you gonna get me while I'm talking? Okay. Some of you are asking for your children, Lord, I want them to be saved. Sight's too low. I don't want them to just be saved, just to be getting into the kingdom. I want them to become a kingdom citizen, fully functional, operating in their gifts, giving you glory, so that the world would know that you are King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Lord, listen, Hannah prayed that. Y'all remember Hannah? Hannah couldn't have nothing. Look, Hannah. Then finally she said, God, if you give me a child, what'd she say? I'll give it back to you. I don't just want a gift. I want a gift that'll glorify you. Co-pastor had a roommate named Tia. Tia couldn't hold a tune in a bucket. Can I be honest with you? She couldn't at first. Beautiful girl, but she couldn't sing. You know what she said? She said, God, now Shabarba was singing all her life. Tia wasn't, though. She said, God, if you allow me to sing, I'll never sing for anybody but you. I don't know. Whatever she prayed, help us, Holy Ghost. That thing, when I tell you, when she opened up her mouth, it sounded like angels jumping out her throat. Why? Because she only wanted to give him glory. God, if you give me a voice, I'll give it back to you all the days of my life. God, if you do this, God, see, your words are important. They're powerful. They're sharper than any two. Listen, when God said, speak the word only, why am I telling you that? Because there's healing in your words. There's healing in your counsel. There's healing in your counsel. That's what coaches are about. They teach you how to walk in victory. There's healing in the things you say. So we got to be careful and more strategic about what we say and when we say it and who we say it to and not get bogged down in the foolishness. So now, when it comes down to it, and I'm almost done, I don't have time to waste words anymore. I used to get so hurt. And I got so hurt one time not too long ago where I got accused of something, then I ended up doing it. You know, a friend of mine was doing all kind of crazy stuff, and I got so hurt that I ended up talking about it. And I was like, you know what? I'm not doing that no more. Why? Because I ain't got no more time for that. I got so many other things I can be using my words on than to be sending them out reckless. Do you know? I gotta go a little further now, so pray for me. I'm almost done. That with your words, you can shift the atmosphere. With your words, you can speak. You can declare. You can talk. I'm going to see our old bishop in a couple of months. Actually, next month, a couple of weeks. Our bishop was building a building. It's years ago. Strange thing was, for some reason, it started raining. Oh, it started raining. It started raining. We couldn't get the building built. It was wasting money. Bishop, in church, he said, we're going to take a quick intermission, but I want you to do this. He said, I'm about to ask God for something. And he said, and if you don't believe it, he said, I want you to just take a few minutes. He said, I'll give you time. I want you to go out in the vestibule. He said, but if you're going to go with me, go with me. That brother Bishop got up there and he prayed. He prayed. And I think it was like January, February, somewhere around there. Sometime around August, he realized that we had one of the longest droughts in that city's history. And somebody said, remember you prayed for, and so he had to get up and pray for the rain to start back. Because the power of life and death is in your tongue. There's power in your agreement as a couple. And so when you agree on things, speak it. You in debt, put it on your refrigerator. We did that one time. Stop speaking to it. I declare and decree by the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that you, God, you said in your word that we would owe no man nothing but love. And so, God, I speak over our debt and I say, be canceled in the name of Jesus. I say, God, that our finances are yours and you are the accountant of our finances. I'm going to give you something to do. Give you some homework. Get a sheet of paper and write the vision and make it plain. Why are we talking about communication? We're talking about words. Write down the vision. You got a vision for your marriage? Write it down. You got a vision for your finances? Write it down. You got a vision for your family? Write it down. You got a vision for your children? Write it down. And watch God begin to make it happen. And speak that. I'm telling you, it'll happen. I'm a living witness. I've been seeing it happen. Declare a thing and it shall be so that light shall shine on your path. Let me make sure I ain't got one more scripture that I was supposed to have gave y'all before I get off here. Nope, did that one. That one. I missed something. He said the power of life and death are in the tongue. And he said, and you will eat the fruit thereof. That's found. I needed to put that last part in there. That's found in Proverbs chapter number 18. There's so many scriptures where he said, the power of life and death are in the tongue, this and that. What am I telling you? That when you speak, speak God's word. You're a man or woman of God. When you speak over yourself. Declare over yourself what the Lord says. Declare it over your children. Declare it over your finances. Declare it over your life. Declare it over your health. Declare it over everything. Declare it over your mind. Why? Because God is faithful. And there's power in your tongue. There's power in your tongue. The power of life and death is in your tongue. So he says this. He says, let therefore no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Let me read that again. But only such as good for building up as it fits the occasion. Make sure it fits the occasion. That it may give grace to those who hear. Can you do me one more favor, Mr. Pringle? And I'll be done. Can you pull up that same 29 in the Amplified version? And so that I won't let no corrupt communication put it out of my mouth and lie, I'm going to close the laptop. All right, y'all ready? It's not always just about cussing. But he says, let no foul or polluting language, nor evil word, nor unwholesome or worthless talk ever, and he said ever, come out of your mouth, but only such speech as good and beneficial to the spiritual progress of others, as it is fitting to the need of the occasion and the occasion, that it may be a blessing and give grace or God's favor to those who hear it. You can stand. Y'all okay? Everybody good? Whether you know it or not, whether you know it or not, when I was in the military, we had training. We had weapons training. Y'all hear me? Weapons training. And we learned how to use our firearm. And he told you that that thing had great propensity. It was strong. And it was to be respected. Why am I telling you that? Your tongue is one of the mightiest weapons you'll ever have. As a believer, your tongue is one of the mightiest weapons you'll ever have. Your tongue can be used for worship. Your tongue can be used for speaking life. Your tongue can be used for adoration. Your tongue can be used to build up, or your tongue can be used for curses. From out of the heart, the mouth speaks. Tongue is a pen of a ready writer. Your tongue can be used to criticize yourself, or your tongue can be used to look in the mirror to say, I am what God said I am, and that no sickness can befall me. If it was not so in the beginning, it has no place in my life. Your tongue can be used to shake nations, to make business deals, to move millions or thousands of dollars. Your tongue can be used to fill a room with laughter. Big use to fill a room with song. Be used to talk somebody off of a bridge or talk somebody on it. Your tongue can be used to talk you into depression and talk you out of it. Your tongue can be used to build your marriage, to build a marriage of respect, or to build bondage. The choice is yours. Your tongue can be used to tell people how grateful you are and to give God thanks. This is when the guy got me on. Or your tongue can be used to complain. I had to learn to stop telling my situation and telling people about my situation, about how bad it was, to stop telling my situation about who God is. I don't know why, but I just keep hearing the song. And you don't have to play, but my God is greater. My God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. My God is healer, awesome in power. My God. Y'all ready for this part? And if my God is for us, then what could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against us? So I tell you this, I want you to begin to use your tongue for the purpose at which it was created, to give him glory. Father, we bless you. I bless you for your people, God. I speak life over them, God. That the power of life and death is in their tongue. And I pray, God, that every negative thing that was spoken against them would be healed. Can y'all just, while I'm doing this, lay hands on the person beside you? Even if you just hold their hand. You just wanted to flirt with me. Amen. I speak life over them. The power of life and death is in their tongue. Can somebody grab Mama Linda? Two. Monica, can you? Okay. The power of life and death is in the tongue. I speak life over them. I speak life over them as they're touching the person that they're touching. I speak, Father, that you would do great and awesome things through them, God. God, I thank you, God, for your child. I thank you, God, that you'll do exceedingly abundantly above all that they can ever ask or think. I thank you, God, that they are children. And so, God, I pray against depression. I pray against any negative thing that would attempt to attach itself to them. I pray, God, that their speech, God, would line up with your word. I thank you, God, that their health would line up with your word. And I thank you, God, that you'll begin the process, God, of showing them how to use that weapon that they call their tongue. That it would be used to glorify you, God. I thank you, God, that it would be used to pass the test and to give a testimony. And so, God, we honor you on today. We praise you and we lift your name high. For it's in Jesus' name that I pray. And I pray that their enemies would come at them one way but flee in seven. Or worship you. I thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. Listen, I want you to go in peace. Amen. And enjoy the favor of the Lord. Amen. Oh. Okay. Real quick.
Just as a reminder, anybody who would like to learn more or interested in evangelism or evangelizing, we're having a quick meeting right after service.
Quick.